an F Street branch opened in 1909, and Riverdale branch opened in 1910. I'd like to take a moment to welcome a few of our special guests today. Representing the provincial government is MPP Joan Shines. Representing the city is Nicholas Gallant, special assistant to our councillor Anna Ballard. Also here from the library board are Benji Wolfhard and Toronto Public Library Board Chair Paul Beansley. Before I turn the podium over to our library board chair, I'd like to tell you a little bit about this wonderful building. Bloor Gladstone has grown and evolved over the years and is a well-loved community cornerstone in this vibrant neighborhood. Today, the branch has almost over 80,000 books, CDs, DVDs, and magazines, and of course, computers and free Wi-Fi. In addition to our English language collection, we also carry materials in Chinese, Hindi, Portuguese, Spanish, and Vietnamese. People that grew up using this library often tell us that they now bring their children and grandchildren here. The library is connected to everything that's happening in this community, and we're looking forward to a very positive future. My own love affair with this branch began in 2005 when I became the branch head. And I know we have a number of people here today who are staff alumni, either working at other locations, as well as retired staff who are visiting the building. Can I see a show of hands of all the staff alumni here today? I would now like to turn the podium over to Toronto Public Library's Board Chair, Councillor Paul Beansley.
It's great to get an anniversary of this building, this community, and above all, the Toronto Public Library system. It actually seems like only yesterday I was here in 2009 as a member of the Toronto Public Library Board of Directors to celebrate the reopening in 2009. Flash forward a few years and back here for the 100th anniversary. And saying that, I'd like to take it back now more than 100 years when Toronto City Council voted to provide, for the first time ever, a small amount of money, $60,000 plus $5,000 for books to the Toronto Public Library Board to build the first ever Toronto Public Library branch to be fully funded by the City of Toronto. Prior to the City Council providing this funding, the previous three branches in the library system were funded by the famed American steel magnate, Andrew Carnegie. Construction on the building we're in today began on April 30, 1912, over 100 years ago on this very day. Dover Court Branch, as it was then known, opened for business. Over the years, we've worked hard to keep the building current, with two major renovations, most recent, as I just mentioned, completed in 2009. Since that renovation, I'm very proud as the board of the chair of the board of directors to announce this building has received 8 different architectural awards, and most recently the prestigious Design Excellence Award handed out by the Ontario Association of Architects. And we're not finished with this beautifying this important Toronto landmark yet. Shortly, our president of the Library Foundation, Heather Rumball, will be telling you about a new important fundraising initiative. But first, I'd like to tell you about an art installation that's just been completed here on the second floor, just around the corner from me. I'm very proud to say a local artist, Eric Wong, wished to make a very special contribution to this centennial celebration. Mr. Wong, who is with us here this evening, Eric, are you? Where's Eric? Derek's right behind me. He's created a beautiful 17-foot-wide artist piece for the East Reading Room on the second floor, as I said behind me, over the mantel. This work of art depicts a continuous wave of colored stripes that are vibrant, jubilant, and very commemorative. On top of the color wave is the 1913 to 2013, symbolizing a century of service that this brand has given to our community. I hope you'll all make your way upstairs after to see it. And I also wanted to note that one of the reasons that Derek made this donation to this grant is he was also part of the arts program exhibitors, program here at the library, and he was able to give back to the grant. And I think that's a wonderful memento and contribution that really symbolizes how important our Toronto Public Library grant is to all members of the community. So on behalf of the Toronto Public Library Board, I would like to thank Mr. Wong for this beautiful piece of artwork, which is sure to delight library customers for many years to come. I want to thank all of you for coming here this evening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening. And once again, I want to thank everybody, and thank all of the staff and the staff alumni that are here this evening, and wish everybody a very happy anniversary. Thank you very much.
Now to turn the podium over to Nicholas Gallant, Special Assistant to Councillor Anna Bilal.
Hello everyone, I'm here on behalf of the House Councillor Anna Bilal. I wish that she could be here with me today, but I've got to count on official city business. I wanted to say, first of all, congratulations on the 100th anniversary. The Council sends her best regards, and she wishes that she could be here because this is a community hub. This is a hub that has been in existence for 100 years and has served so many people so well. The Council herself was integrated into this community in part through this library. It's part of the hub that radiates into the neighborhood and radiates throughout the whole city. And it is so important, and I hope that it continues on for hundreds more years to come. Thank you.
I grew up in a family. Who loved reading, and I read with my mom and dad and my brothers and sister, and I learned about the world that way, and I learned about our history, and it formed my values, my political values, and it makes me feel good to be here to know that families across the city can come here and read together. I think that this place and public libraries, I'm telling you, they're very simple things. We think of them as simple, and as you know, through the modern technology, but they are simply beautiful to me because they provide us spaces to come together. It makes me feel good to know that somebody can come here after school and use a computer and do their homework. It makes me feel good to know that we can come together as a community and use this space here. It makes me feel good to know that somebody who is cold on the street can come in here and warm up on a cold day. And it makes me feel good to know that in a time where it feels like there's sometimes a war on science, a war on knowledge, and a war on truth from our political leaders, that people are here plowing through books, plowing through a diversity of ideas and opinions to work to make this place a better world for all of us. I want to thank all of you for being here, for celebrating the 100th year together, and to help us remember that this is what we can do when we're together. Public libraries are absolutely possible. They speak to the kind of public services that we can have and bring together. And so I want to make sure that we do this again. And I'm going to try to call a scroll. You're asking exactly what I'm doing. This is a recognition of the 100th anniversary of the library here. This is a gift of Bloor back to the library and their past. Gloria has come up for a few minutes. She says, with this certificate, the celebration of the 100th anniversary of the public library makes Toronto an equitable, engaged, and vibrant city. Bloor back to the library made a power collection. Thank you very much for your work. Thank you.
Probably already know that the foundation works with people who care about the library and want to make a difference. We have a number of donors, in fact, who have made donations to this very branch. One of them is a gentleman named John O'Honan, a former resident of this neighborhood, and he left a gift in his will that enabled the library to create the Kids Stop that I'm sure you've all seen on the little cover here in the children's area. Kids Stops are fun, interactive, literacy-rich, very tactile learning environments designed for children from ages birth to five to play and learn struggles with their caregivers. They feature a wide range of activities based on the library's innovative Ready for Reading program that supports the six key pre-literacy skills children need in order to be ready to learn to read when they get to school. Essentially, those skills are, I like books, I really enjoy books, I hear words, that's hearing and recognizing smaller sounds in words, I know words, knowing more words makes learning reading easier, I can tell a story, that's using words to tell a story, I see words, making a connection between spoken and written words, and I know letters, knowing the names and sounds of letters. Now, as generous as Mr. Cohen's gift was, it didn't enable the library to fully equip the Bloor Gladstone Kids Stop with all the components needed to build those six main reading skills in our youngest community members, which is why we launched the Bloor Gladstone Contemporary Campaign. Our goal, hopefully with your help, is to raise $15,000 to add three major new components to the Kids Stop. One is a special bench, the second is four book returns, and the third is a big book. The kettle bench, or the flower belt, will have activities that help link everyday objects to the letters of the alphabet in a very tactile way, strengthening the I know writer's skill. The toy book return emphasizes the notion of borrowing and returning books, a very important skill. But even more importantly, building special awareness in toddlers and developing in them that I like book skill. And the big book, which is exactly that, the big oversized book, provides the caregiver and the child a chance to share a story in a way that creates a sense of actually being part of the story. And appropriately enough, the big book builds on all caregivers being skilled, especially I like books and I see words from. So during this centenary year, your support for this project would be most appreciated. Lisa and I, Lisa down there waiting, will be manning a table that you want to point to it just over here underneath at the back. Where we'll have some more information. We'll be happy to answer questions and, of course, your information form as well. If you choose to become a centenary partner, that's by making a donation of $1,000 or more to this project. You can do that in your own name or honor somebody that you love. Your name or that name will be placed on a plaque that will be mounted near the Kids Stop once the project is complete. So I hope you'll consider making a gift to help establish the future of these young readers and readers to be, and I hope you enjoy yourself for the rest of the evening. Thank you.
In the program room, down the ramp to your left or to your right, enjoy the entertainment, and above all, of your day at the library. Have a wonderful evening.
Problem, that's where